Junky here. It's the Pat and JT Podcast.
Pat and JT Podcast.
Thanks for all your texts, 402-403-9478. Appreciate that. Also, Instagram, Twitter, and Facebook, it's Pat and JT. Thanks for listening to our podcast.
Oh, my gosh. All right, so where do we start? So much stuff going on. I don't even know. Not even going to touch politics. We're out of that. But the Iron Caucus is coming up soon. That is true. We are aware. But that's okay.
Yeah, we know that, so we don't have to talk about it. We know that it's coming.
Plenty of other people that want to talk about it.
Let them do it, right?
Let them do it. Instead, I'd rather talk about what we consider our legal update, legal news updates. And I have nothing about the Royals today either.
Okay.
Just so you know, Meg's it. We're going to leave it alone for a little while. Lori Loughlin back in the news. And that whole scheme with the college entrance exam scheme, et cetera, that where they paid about $500,000 so their daughters could pose as athletes for USC and also allegedly bribed some employees. They pled not guilty last year. We knew that. Now, last Friday, so just like 4 or 5 days ago, federal prosecutors said that a lot of the parents, including Lori and her husband, haven't submitted all their discovery materials. So all the evidence that they say is in their favor, they haven't proved, they haven't submitted it.
I would have had that there the next day. If it's to defend me and to prove my point, it would have been there the next day. What are you dragging your feet for?
Yeah, and both sides have to do this. Both sides have to submit their discovery information or evidence that they share so that they have a chance to know what's coming, really. And the government is saying that they did what they were supposed to do, but apparently her attorneys and other attorneys are saying that, well, the government hasn't really provided us with enough discovery. It's like, man, I don't want to play chicken with the government right now.
No, they don't care.
Not in this deal, because they're both looking at some pretty serious charges, and they said that there's information that the government hasn't released that would be in their favor when it comes to the charges about whether or not they were aware that the money was used to bribe officials. Okay, so
where else would the money be going?
So $500,000. They knew that they were pretending that their children were athletes.
So it's not saying that they paid $500,000 to someone to whatever cook up some sort of thing that their kid was an athlete, but they didn't know it was actually going to pay someone at the school to let him in.
Right. Okay. A lot of that,
I can see that.
Some of that money went to coaches.
I got it. So they didn't necessarily know that.
They knew it was all wrong.
Right. Oh, 100%.
They knew it was 100% wrong. How wrong, or specifically what was wrong? Maybe not the details.
Splitting hairs a little bit.
$500,000 and their children acted like they were rowing.
Yeah. They knew that wasn't right. It didn't feel right.
And they aren't rowers.
Yeah, get your stuff in, so, man. If it's used to defend you, you walk that stuff to the courthouse today, to your lawyer's office today. Get it done.
Oh yeah, exactly. Evidence either way.
Why would you not?
Just get it done. But I know that there is, again, the phrase playing chicken. Again, that comes up because I know that's kind of part of the law, you know, and trying to do that little dance. But man, when you're looking at some serious jail time, which she is, yeah, I would say.
Yeah. Nope.
Let's just, well, she already passed on the bar, you know, taking the play.
Yeah.
She already passed on that, which was a big boo-boo.
Which was kind of a gamble right there.
Yeah, it was.
Playing chicken sort of situation.
She was.
So
she was.
That's, don't do it twice.
Yes. So it could have been all done and over with by now. But now let's talk about Michael Avenatti.
Dirtbag. Porn lawyer.
Former Stormy Daniels attorney. You haven't heard her name lately either, have you? In the wind. He got arrested.
Again?
So, yeah, just the other night. Within the last 24 hours, I do believe it was.
Okay.
24, 48 hours. Anyway, what happened is, it happened outside of a disciplinary hearing that was being held by the State Bar of California, because they'd accused him of using doctored documents to scam a client out of about $840,000.
Yeah.
And so they were doing that, and anyway, they said that they're trying to put him on inactive status. But there was a break in the testimony. So members of the United States Attorney's Office for the Central District of California, who are prosecuting a separate criminal matter in Orange County, parlayed the opportunity and took him into custody. Because apparently they're saying he has been arrested because he violated the terms of his release on the other charges.
Oh.
So he's still able to practice law at this point, but that's what they were trying to make sure.
Who on earth would hire him?
I don't know. Right now, he's basically in defense mode for himself on several different fronts. So he's got the scam with the client that he took money from, and then he's got the other scam, which had to do with the Nike thing.
Yeah.
And that's what this came from.
And this along the same lines as the Lori Loughlin thing, you broke the terms of your release or whatever. Why would you? I would have those tattooed on my forearm. So I knew exactly what I was doing, and every single thing that I did was in the line of that. I don't want to spend any time in jail.
He was taken into custody. So when court resumed on his other case, his lead counsel told the court that in connection with a criminal matter in Santa Ana, Avenatti's unable to return to court. So that's because he's in jail.
He's in jail. He's in the back of a police car on the way to county right now.
So he's expected, speak right now, possibly or within this 24-hour time span, that he'll be appearing in federal court to find out what's going to happen there. But of course, he has to always get the last word as he's let out of court. And normally much more, much more outspoken, but he just completely innocent.
Yeah.
That's all he said.
Of course, we get it.
Completely innocent.
And we believe you. We believe you.
Good. So anyway.
Just like we believe Iran and everything Iran says and the government when they tell Canada anybody. That they promise they're gonna participate and they're gonna help with the investigation of who shot down that plane. I trust them. I really. And Trudeau sounded like he trusted him. He's like, They said.
They
even said it like this. They said they're gonna help us. So we trust them. All right. Okay. Trust them then.
I don't think that would be the road I would take.
No, but whatever.
Okay, that's one you want to take. All right, so the last couple of stories that I've got here, one of them this is really a cool one because I really like Alex Trebek. And especially after a couple years he's had health-wise. And he is barreling right through and just a real hero. And they had the champions, the GOAT, basically. They were doing the Jeopardy Greatest of All Time special tournament. And it wrapped up. And of course, Ken Jennings.
He won it, yeah.
Can't keep him down.
He's the man.
And the deal was the first to win three matches. I think there's like three matches and do something else, whatever, then you were the grand champion, and he was the one to achieve that. So he also got another $1 million, and he's got his runners-up, James Holzhauer and Brad Rutter, and they each got about $250,000. But Jennings' claim to fame was 74 games in a row, that winning streak, longest in the show's history. And his winnings... $4.37 million.
That's crazy.
Game show winnings. Isn't Jeez. That something?
Yeah, that's awesome.
Brad Rutter, he on the last question of the match, and I can't remember, it was some Shakespeare question, so you don't want me to quote it. Anyway, it was he bowed out, and as he is taken to do when he didn't know the right answer, like on Daily Doubles and things like that, he would write down a message to Alex. Especially during his health scare or and other things that were going on. And he just wrote, "You're the best, Alex!" exclamation point. And when Trebek, of course, they show the answer, so Trebek has to read it. And he says, "Well, that is incorrect." And Rutter said, "I think it's true and I should get credit for it." I thought that was kind of cool, though. But they did it.
Did you see that? It was about 6 weeks ago, I think. There was another contestant that did that for the first time that didn't know the answer and wrote a message to Alex. And he started to cry, kind of choked him up.
Just said,
We love you, Alex. Yeah.
Yes.
Yeah, it was really pretty cool.
I think that's a neat thing to do because that's something that is fairly recent. You know, yeah. It's like all of a sudden, oh, hey, I can do something. I can be kind of funny here. I can have a good time. And Trebek got his share of teasing as well. But this is kind of funny. He was loving this competition because he's got three brilliant contestants, no doubt. And this is funny because he had confirmed what everybody's already suspected. He said he loves spending time with bright people and he hates spending time with stupid people.
All right. Makes sense. That's funny.
I like that. I like that. I appreciate that. Okay. You may have heard, I don't know, if you have an Android, my phone, I don't think it ever did on the podcast.
No, that wasn't you. That was your tablet. Your tablet was constantly updated. Well, the tablet did
it too, but my phone would all of a sudden, boop, 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 boop. It was like notifications, and I get all these notifications that apps were updating.
That's why you need to get an iPhone. Don't get an Android.
No, this is here's the story, and I feel really stupid, but I'm going to share. At the Android police, they say that the notifications were something that were annoying everybody. because they would every time you updated an app. So if you have a lot of apps, every time it updates all the apps, it would tell you one at a time that it updated the app. And so they said that in November, you may have noticed fewer notifications. I didn't notice it then, but I did notice it about a month ago in December because it was back and forth in through November and in through December. And I was like, that's weird because I'm not getting all those notifications. And I didn't, but not, I'm not curious enough to go look to find out why, because I really didn't care. I was just glad they were gone. But they said that largely now you'll find the notifications are absent, and that's going to continue that way. But as it turns out, muting those update alerts has always been an option. All you had to do was go in the notification section, and you could find to mute the app update notifications. You could always have done that.
Forever. It's not just a new thing.
Right? And so Google says, okay, since you guys aren't smart enough to do that, we're going to make that the default.
Right, because you don't need to, if it's being updated automatically, why do you need to be notified? You're telling it to update automatically. You don't need to tell me you're doing it.
Just tell me when it's all done. That would be okay too.
Do it.
One notification. So now they said, okay, it's the default behavior. And now if you want to know, you can go in and you can change it so you find out when that happens. But it's always been the default. It's always been able, you've always been able to turn it on.
Who would think that?
I cussed at it. It's like, God, this thing is, why does it keep doing this?
Like, shut up.
Mute.
Right. Did you turn it off?
Oh my God.
We've got some text to get through.
Yeah, go ahead. Cause I'm going to say this last story. You mentioned this last story. It comes from Kansas and Iowa, but it's from Kansas via Iowa.
Okay.
Can't get much better than that. That's going to be coming up. That's going to be great.
Rolling into 2020. Want to thank Kugler Vision for supporting our podcast, the Pat and JT podcast.
They've been with us practically from the beginning and couldn't be happier to be associated with them and all the great things that they're doing. Dr. Kugler and the entire staff, they're just first class people in general, but first class facility, no doubt. They lead the pack really when it comes to the technology, when it comes to having those procedures done that are going to completely change the way you see everything. Pat and I both had procedures done and I only wish I'd done it sooner. And a lot of people, I think, stay away from because they're a little nervous about it.
They don't know what it's all about. So
right.
You can go to their website. You can go in. You can get a consultation. We were in the office just the other day and walking through there. You're reminded as how streamlined the process is, how non-intimidating it is, and how you know at the end of it, you're going to get a cookie, a delicious cookie.
They do. Right when you walk in the front door, as a matter of fact, Corey was at the desk and she gets you checked in and whoever you're there to see. And the doctors there really know their stuff.
More information, if you are maybe just thinking about for the very first time getting any sort of procedure like that, there's so much information on kuglervision.com. You can go there and you can find out everything. You can schedule your consultation.
Yeah.
You can find out about all the different procedures they offer. And then you can go in and find out if you're a candidate.
That's what a lot of people don't realize too, is there's not just one procedure that you can have done. I think there's seven.
Seven, yeah.
And depending on what your eyes require, they run you through a battery of tests and then they tell you these are your options. And then you let them kind of guide you as to what is going to benefit you the most for the long run. And we're excited to be working with them this year because obviously it's 2020.
Right. So there, you know, this, and if you're thinking about this at all, ever, this is the universe telling you you're in 2020. Maybe you can see as close to 2020 as possible. So this is the time you need to go into Kugler Vision.
Absolutely. And remember this promo code PatentJT2020. But check in at their website at kuglervision.com for more details.
And thank you, Kugler Vision. Okay. So 402-403-9478. This is from Janelle. It says, hey, Janelle. Oh, no, it says, hey, Pat and JT. We're saying hi, Janelle. Speaking of the PNS plates, talking about the Nebraska plates yesterday with the first three letters, PNS.
Yes.
My sister is a groomer and tried to get doggy style. Not sure how she would abbreviate it, but they kiboshed that. And then also on the neighborhood,
gutter minds.
The neighbor parking in front of your car, house situation. On the opposite side of the street, he'd park his POS car that he never drove in front of his neighbor's house. He's a douche anyway. So we all collectively reported it and they ticketed him. Yeah, this took a few times and then they finally towed it.
Really?
To the dump, probably.
So even the tickets didn't even get him to...
Usually, I could understand. We had, when we called the police and they put not a ticket, but they put like a red tag on the back, like a tow, whatever, get 24 hours to move it. They moved it just into their driveway, kept the tag on the back of it, just moved it in the driveway. And 3 days later, pulled the tag off, moved it right back.
Oh my God.
I don't understand why people don't have a little more pride
at that point. That's intentional.
Right.
Before you were just kind of like, I'll just take a chance and we'll just risk it and see what happens.
Yeah.
Now you know they're pissed. And you're going to go ahead and put it back.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Stupid.
All right.
This is from Jennifer. She said, literally singing Hot Potato from the Wiggles. The second I mentioned the Wiggles, yeah, I also randomly get the fruit salad song stuck in my head. Fruit salad, yummy, yummy. Yes, me too. I also don't mind Blippi. Whatever, Blippi.
Blippi, remember that was the YouTube channel Amy, I think it was Amy's, I'm not sure, child, two-year-old?
Yeah, that's right.
Yeah.
Happy hump day. Thank you. That was yesterday. That was sent.
Nice.
So 402-403-9478. Text us. You can also leave us a voicemail there as well.
Wanted to throw it to, and hopefully in the next couple of days, we're going to be hearing from Megan Swanson and her sister. They just so happen to be both Miss Nebraska's, Miss Nebraska America, Miss Nebraska USA. And Megan's been on our show before. She's been on with us. Talking about her company and the things that she does with young women. As a former pageant contestant, she tries to dive into the good side of pageants. And it's just not the outside, the way you look. It's the way you carry yourself, the confidence that you have, the inner conversations that you have, and works with people on, or the girls in particular, works on their interview skills. And again, that inner dialogue and being aware of the world, and she's done a great job with her contestants. They've been just killing it.
Yeah, all over the
country.
So then
all of a sudden we hear Megan's going to be running for Miss Nebraska USA, and that competition was just held recently, and she did great and won it.
So two sisters hold both crowns. That's incredible.
Two Miss Nebraskas.
Yeah.
So then they're both like 6 foot and 6 foot two. And they're
just going to be a great, I love getting pictures with tall ladies. So it's going to be a great picture if they come in. I can't wait.
So we should be talking to them in the next few days, and we'll have them on the podcast, which I'm really excited about.
It'll be super fun.
How her whole powerhouse pageantry is doing and all her other contestants. And now back to Kansas via Iowa, or Iowa via Kansas. No, it's Kansas via, because it's a Kansas man asking an Iowa judge for some help. He apparently, okay. His name's David. And David said in a filing on January 3rd that his wife, Bridget, or former wife, and her attorney, Matt Hudson, had destroyed him legally. They've been in disputes over custody and visitation issues, property tax payments. And the judge had the power to let the parties resolve their disputes on the field of choice, so to speak, however they wanted to do it, that they'd be able to do this. And he added in his filing that... this had never been explicitly banned or restricted as a right in the United States. He was asking his attorney, or the judge, I'm sorry, to let him engage in a sword fight with his ex-wife.
Oh, God. My lips to God's ears. Forget. Let's go. Let that be an option.
His ex-wife and her attorney, so that he can, quote, rend their souls from their bodies.
I bet he does. I bet he would have won in 3 seconds.
He also asked for,
holy cow. Says,
and by the way, Judge, I need about 12 weeks so I can get some Japanese samurai swords.
That's good job for trying, buddy.
And it's so funny. Again, Harold or David, he says, I think I've met her attorney's absurdity with my own absurdity, adding that his former wife had chosen this attorney to act as her champion and had argued that his legal response was because of a duel could end in death. Such ramifications likely outweigh those of property tax and custody issues. And the attorney asked the judge to reject the request for trial by combat. The judge, if I were the judge, wouldn't you just be like,
I'm going to go to my
let me go think about this.
I'm going to go to my chambers for a couple of days and just think about this. Make her sweat a little bit.
So in his filing, he said he won't be issuing any decisions anytime soon, citing irregularities with both the motions and responses. And until proper procedural steps to initiate a court proceeding are followed, this court will take no further action concerning any motion by either party.
So he just kind of peed on that parade. That's great.
He's like, both of you, stop
it. Go to your rooms and think about what you've done. You guys are a couple of children.
And they wonder why this drags on and on,
right?
And on. Somebody has got to just take a knee and say, I'm done with this, okay? I'm done. This is getting ridiculous.
I laughed so hard yesterday when I saw that. You gotta be kidding me.
Can I have about 3 months to go acquire the swords, please? No.
You guys, you can connect with us on Facebook, It's Pat and JT, or Instagram and Twitter, It's Pat and JT, or 402-403-9478. Appreciate that you guys are listening to our podcast. Go to patandjt.com.
Pat and JT Podcast. Podcast, a Parkville Media Production.